Just a quick travel tip, if you've wondered what the bidet is or trying to use the bidet, I recommend not to YouTube how to use the bidet. Absolutely horrific. It's just a bunch of guys that look like Frank Longwell. Using the bidet.
It's easy.
Obviously, some of you may know, I wasn't the first choice for best man. Going to get emotional. Celeste told me this just recently, but Mark's first choice for best man was himself. He loves himself. There's nothing more he would rather do than get up here and talk about how great he is. Oh my God, he would fantasize about him being the best man for so long. Sorry to break your heart. Celeste is like, that's weird. You can't do that. You gotta pick somebody else. And he's like, fine. I hate you. Okay, sure. Thanks. I'll be with us, man. This is beautiful. So, let's go back in time here to 1982. What happened? I was 2 years old, and my parents were concerned because I didn't have any friends. Surprise! Me? No friend? And my parents were so worried. Yes, my mom's like, he's not a friend. He just sits there and talks to the wall. I'm really worried about him. He has no friends. Chop out. And my dad looks at my mom and he says, let's get him a buddy. He's a romantic. And I'm like, oh God, he's so romantic. Let's get him a buddy. I'm ready. My dad is a very dying romance. Let's make him a buddy. So, a couple months later, in September 21st, 1982, we went to the orphanage and signed the adoption paper. Oh my God! You can even tell? Jesus, my God, Mom. You're adopted. Weird to say this, but you are 100% Greek and this is a waste of time. Oh my God, this entire thing's a sham. You're Greek, dude! We're totally in the wrong country. And and your real birth name is Jesse Gonsalves. It's from Full House. Whatever happened to the dishes of the hood? Never the people. Anyway, I don't know if you sing that the rest of my story. So that was 1982. You were bored, and I got my buddy. And growing up with Mark was good, I think. He had a lot of nicknames growing up. Farzy, Farz, Matt, because we were ending at, so we'd say Matt. Chubby Cheeks, because he was a fat ass. So I had Mark the Spark, but the words closest to him just called him Dunk. But he, I'm not saying, I didn't say he's dumb. But Mark knew he was dumb.
He comes home with, like, just, you know, C's for gym class. But he was under C. He knew he was dumb. And he would just, and my mom and dad were like, Mark, what's this all about, man? And he's like, Mom, Dad, you don't get it. I don't have book smarts, but I have street smarts. And I'm like, street smarts? You seriously live in the most relaxed suburb of Pennsylvania. There's no street smarts there, buddy. You gotta be kidding me. Just because you know the name of your street doesn't mean you have street smarts. Okay? Jesus Christ. But I'll tell you what, that kid, fast forward to 2005, that dumb kid graduated Temple University. Congratulations. And I drove him home from graduation that day, from Temple graduation, and I was driving him home, and I said, so what are you going to do now, man? College is done. And he goes, I'm going to be a full-time sports radio host on WIP. And I just couldn't help but chuckle, because he said it so matter-of-fact. And 13 years later, you're still not. And she was so sweet and nice, and she just kept talking about the weekend date. Our day, our first date was one weekend long. And I was like, she's friendly. And she's a friendly lady. And Mark's just like, yeah. And my mom's like the church lady from Saturday.
Oh, really? Oh, weekend. Oh, me. Who said that thing? I'm
thinking. And I said, I was just chatting with Celeste, and I said, so what do you do? And she's like, oh, I am a smart, high energy public relations strategist with new and creative ideas to move the needle for my healthcare clients. And she said, you may recognize this. And then she went on and she's like, I bring the same drive and leadership as I did on my college volleyball team. And then she went on and she goes, and for years I have tremendous experience in my strengths, resign in product launch, issues resolution, and... Oh, shoot. There's no way I would memorize your bio on the website of your company that I don't see on Google. I want to memorize your entire bio. Where did you get that idea? This was all from the heart. So, Celeste, I first met you, I knew you were the one, and I'm going to cry now. I knew you were the one because of what you were and what you weren't. And what you were was beautiful, smart, funny, and intelligent. And what you weren't was a psycho demon from the depths of hell. Because all the other girls were high, like, we completely go around. Paul Majoris, he saved us a lot. Paul Majoris exercised that demon. It's off his plane. By the way, I did see one of your ex-girlfriends. I don't want to name names because it's like Beetlejuice if you say the name three times. I did see one of your exes at the airport in Rome. So weird. And she was alone, and she said she was going to a wedding in Seattle, too. Oh my gosh, she's over there. Just kidding, she's not going to kill us. Just don't say her name, I'm going to say. Okay, this is from Zio Marco. "Sorry, I can't make your wedding. I am busy at school. But I guess this makes us even for all the times you went to football games instead of coming to my birthday party." Oh my God, I'm sorry. And then he curses, he calls you a poopy bump face. And then he says, "I wish Willie was my God." Oh my God, he said, "I wish Willie was my God." I don't even know if you want that. Okay. So, time to get a little serious and cry. All day today, I was saying to Mark, "Hey, you're not heavy." And he didn't understand why. And after like the fourth time I said, "Hey, you're not heavy," he's like, "Listen, I have gained a few pounds, okay?" And I'm like, "It's not about your weight." And basically there's a little story of a little girl who is carrying her baby brother, and somebody says, "Hey, that baby looks pretty heavy." And she goes, "Oh, he's not heavy, he's my brother." And there's a song about it. Neil Diamond did a cover of it. The Hollies did a cover of this song, and it just kind of reminded me of Mark and I. And the thing is that we've had some great times. You know, we have made weird horror movies, or we've made movies with our camcorders. We've played catch. We've had some difficulties with moves as kids. We've had to move around a lot, and it was tough for Mark and moving around and. We had some tough times, and you know, lost loved ones along the way. But I've always had my buddy. Thanks, jerk. Jeez. Always had my buddy. So the song. I was gonna read a lyric, but I just rather sing it because it's stupid. Let's see here. He's not heavy. He's my brother. His welfare is my concern. No burden is he to bear. We'll get there. And I'm strong, strong to carry you. You're not heavy. You're my brother, and you're my sister. Guys, no matter how much of a burden you ever think it is, Cam and I are here for you. Okay, I'm going to take this. And we're here for you. We're going to love you, help you, in good times and bad, as you give each other's vows. Those extend outward to your brother, to your buddy. And you've got great role models in marriage with Frank and Mary, with Joe and Elmer. And just to prove the support, if everyone wants to, if you want to support these two, raise your hand, raise your glass, people. If you want to support these two and love them forever,
amen.
God bless. Cheers.
Today, thank you for speaking, including my brother. We wanted to thank you guys for not only throwing your vacation at this, but also your time, and just coming out here to celebrate this amazing day with us. And a quick reminder, your name tags on the little bottles of olive oil, those are for you to take with you, so please do so. Dave, do you want to say
anything? Thank you for being here. We love you all. And now it's time to dance our asses. Oh. Yeah.